Welcome back, everybody, to the Rhode Show this morning in the Buzz. As we've mentioned, today is Ash Wednesday, marking the start of the Lenten season for Christians. And Pope Francis is going to mark his first Ash Wednesday as the head of the Catholic Church today. The Holy Father will celebrate a Mass at the Vatican today in which he will bless and distribute ashes. Here in New England, however, several Tiverton churches are uniting to offer busy Christians a chance to mark the beginning of Lent today without getting out of their car. This program is called, I love this title, Ashes to Go. So we wanted to know what everybody thinks of it and what are you giving up for the Lenten season?
I think this is a fabulous idea.
I do too.
I think it is so great because I can't tell you how many times people are searching to find a location right. That has a particular time that you can hop out of the office, mm-hmm. maybe take your lunch break.
Right.
Not everyone gets their lunch break or they, you know, they work odd hours. So having this drive-through ashes program
is a good thing.
Is perfect. And I think a lot of people are respect that and admire that and are grateful of it because if there wasn't that option, they probably would not be able to get their ashes.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea. Better to be able to go out and get it. Sometimes you're able to go on your lunch hour, mm-hmm. but if you have to go to Mass to get it, a lot of people don't have that much time to be able to get out. By the time
yeah.
you get out, you're supposed to be back at work. And mm-hmm. I was saying this morning, there was a church or in Providence at one time that would line up some of the priests and people would be able to just walk up and get their ashes
yeah.
because everybody in Providence was busy working. But I say, why not? Mm-hmm. Why not? If you really want to get your ashes, go for it.
Yeah, I don't find it offensive in any way.
No.
It's not that people are skipping
no,
church to do that. I mean, it's either that or nothing, for a lot of
sure.
people.
Right.
So that's a good option.
All right, let's talk about, are you giving up anything?
Well, you can also do something, too.
Yeah.
And I like to remind people of that. You don't always have to give something up.
Mm-hmm.
You can do something. I have to look, too. I can't give up coffee because I drank it today.
Yes.
I can't give up oatmeal because I ate
you
that.
You already
today.
Had that.
You have to think about what you've already done and make sure it's none of those things. But I don't know. I don't know yet. I haven't thought of one.
I was saying to Chef George this morning, because me, I am so fussy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so picky. I'm not a seafood guy. I don't know how I've survived.
You're going to eat fish every day?
You would love if I did. You would love it.
Come on.
Everybody's tried. No one succeeded.
How about on Friday when everyone else is eating
their
fish?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm a meat and potatoes guy. I've tried. That's what, when this time of year comes, it's so hard.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I'm trying to think of what I can do.
Give up steak.
I've tried that before, like to give up meat and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then I always end up having, like, I'll get pizza, something with, like, pepperoni on it, something.
And then
like,
well, mid-bite, you're thinking,
yeah,
oh,
like,
no.
Well, it's over. I might as well finish it at this point.
Hey, I've done junk food before. I'm going to have to think of a good one this year. Brendan, are you doing anything or giving anything up for Lent?
Yeah, I'm actually giving up church for Lent.
No.
I think that would be the ultimate sacrifice.
He said it, not me.
No,
I'm
just kidding.
Not a good idea.
I was thinking about coffee, maybe. You guys know me. I love my iced coffee, so thinking about maybe
you drink one today.
I know. Well, here's what our Facebook friends are saying about
God is watching.
Stop it. Here's what our Facebook friends are saying this morning.
He watches a Rhode Show every day.
All right, let me get to the comments. Margarita Cruz kicks things off today saying, if you can't take the time to go into church and get your ashes, maybe you shouldn't get them at all. All right, continuing things, Carol Sandre Saro says, Lent isn't only about giving up things. It's also about doing more to become a better person.
I'm with you, Carol.
There you go. Donna Mitchell adds, I don't give up anything for Lent. What I try to do is go out of my way to help someone else.
Nice.
So maybe I am giving up myself. There you go. And Katarina Faria Alves closes things out this morning with a good point, saying Lent is not a holy day of obligation. So therefore, I think it's not a bad idea. That's an excellent point right there.